So today we are going to practice yoga for strength. So this class mostly will work on strengthening. As you guys all know that yoga is a very good combination of flexibility, balance and strength. And today's class we will be focusing especially on to strength, where you will be working on your arms, on your legs, on your core. So everything you will be taking care of, and this is going to be amazing. You're also going to strengthen the muscles, and at the same time you're also going to strengthen the internal organs, which is also very important. And this class will also help you tone up your body. So if you feel a little bulky, if you feel your skin is a little loose on your thighs, on your arms or wherever, so this class is surely going to help you. So I'm just going to keep the comments off, so if you have to ask anything or say something, please write in the question box, or you can ask me towards the end of the class. I'll be answering all your questions, and then let's get started. Okay, let's start. Sit on your mats comfortably. Keep your spine straight. Rest your hands on your knees in Chin Mudra and close your eyes gently. Take a deep inhale. Exhale completely. Inhale deeply. Exhale completely. Relax your shoulders and neck. Relax your body completely. Let go of all the stress, worries, tensions. Everything that's holding you back. Relaxing your mind and body, we are going to start the class with one chant of Omkara. Take a deep inhale. Of Omkara chants. Feel the positivities and rub your palms. Make it warm. Cup your eyes. Feel the warmth. Slowly open your eyes and look at the palms. Namaste everyone. So we are going to start the class obviously with our stretching, because no matter what flow you're going to practice, even if you're going to work on your strength, it's very important that your muscles are well prepared before you put pressure on them. You want them to be stretched and warmed up. So we're going to start with stretching. So you come onto your palms and knees in your all fours, keeping your shoulders and wrists aligned, knees and hips aligned. As you inhale, just press your spine down, lift your hips up, pressing your chest down, look up, making a nice arch in the back. Exhale, roll your spine up, and hunch your back. Look to the navel. Inhale and up. Look up, making a nice arch. Exhale and hunch. Inhale and up. Exhale and hunch. Inhale and up. Exhale and hunch and relax. Come back to your neutral spine. Now place your right palm in the center, and while inhaling, stretch your left arm up. Look at the ceiling and twist your body. Stay here for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. As you exhale, drop the left shoulder completely onto your mat. Stretch your right arm forward and balance. Twist here. Now if you can easily balance, then you can stretch your arm up and open up to the other side. Wrap it around your waist. Keep looking up. 5, 4, 3, 2,
and one. Inhale, come back center. This time, placing your left hand in the center. Stretch your right arm up. Look at the ceiling and hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Exhale, dropping your right shoulder entirely onto the mat. Stretch your left arm forward and balance. Once you can feel, you can easily balance. You're going to stretch the arm up and wrap it around your waist. Don't forget to open that shoulder a little, push it towards the left. Keep looking up and hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bringing your palms down, come back center. And your body is nicely stretched, walking a little more on the lower body. So you want to walk one step forward with your palms, lift your knees, come into down dog. Now start pedaling up your legs, bend one knee and the other. As this is the first down dog of your class, you want to make it a little spacious. You just want to walk a little bit. Keep breathing. Keep bending one knee and the other. And relax. Now from here, you're just simply going to stretch your right leg up, keeping the hips square to the mat. Don't forget that your hip should be square and the left heel should be grounded. Keep the right toe flexed, pushing your spine in. You're going to bend the knee and bring it forward between the palms. Keeping your left hand down, press your pelvic a little and stretch your right arm up and look up towards the ceiling. And hold. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Place the right palm down. Take the right leg back. You're going to change side. So stretch your left leg up. Hip square to the mat. Pushing your chest a little in. Bend the knee. Step the left foot forward. Keeping your right hand down. Press your pelvic a little. And stretch your left arm up. So you're basically twisting. This is going to work a lot on strengthening your leg and your arm. Stay there. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Place your palm down, step the left foot back and relax your body. Now from here, you're just simply going to walk forward and come on the top of your mat and soften your knees here. Bend your knees. Hold your opposite elbows and then start moving side to side. I'm so sorry guys. हाँ बाबू मैं क्लास ले रही हूँ बाहर जाओ हाँ गुड्डू आप बाहर जाओ मैं क्लास ले रही हूँ ना सॉरी गाइस दैट्स माय यंगर ब्रदर एंड यू मूव साइड टू साइड अ लिटिल कीप ब्रीदिंग डीप एंड लॉन्ग एंड स्लोली रिलैक्स यू गोना स्ट्रेटन योर नीज एंड रोल अप कम एट योर टॉप ऑफ द मैट स्टैंडिंग एंड रिलैक्स. So you must be feeling nicely stretched with your body. So we're going to do 2 rounds of Surya Namaskara. So today we'll not be going like very fast. I want you to hold each and every pose as this is the strength flow. And when you work on Surya Namaskara, and if you work with every pose holding, then you will realize how strengthening even the Surya Namaskara can be. And mostly we're going to do the Vinyasa one. So this is going to be amazing if you do the Chaturanga. And I have a lot of requests that please teach how to do Chaturanga. If you are a beginner, if you cannot go all the way into it, so how we can go like step by step. So I'm also going to be teaching that. So let's start with Surya Namaskara. We'll hold every pose. Alright, so you come on the top of your mat. Keep your feet together. Engage your thighs. Engage your core. Inhale and stretch your arms up. Keep your palms together into Namaskara and gaze at your thumbs. Keep lengthening your spine here and breathe 3 times. Make sure that you are drawing your navel in towards the spine with every breath. And relax. Now pushing your hips slightly back. Fold forward. Place your palms beside your feet as this is the just first round. So you don't want to push a lot. So you stay in your Uttanasana and hold for 3 breaths. Let your hamstring stretch. Now if you have any back related issues, then you can keep your knees softly bent. That's alright. And breathe again. 3 breaths here. And relax. Now keeping your hands onto your either on the mat or on the shins. Depends on your flexibility. You want to push your hips back and chest up. Shoulders away from your ears and look up, making a nice flat back. and hold for 3 breaths. This is an amazing pose to work a little extra on your hamstrings, on your back. It improves the flexibility of both your legs and back. And then when you exhale, you want to bend your knees, keeping your palms tucked, step back. Alright, and teaching you the Chaturanga. So the alignment in Chaturanga is very, very important. So I'll be just breaking it down into steps. So we'll be teaching you, it's not like every time you go to Chaturanga, you have to check the alignment and everything. No, it's not like that. You may take a week or maybe 2 weeks to be regular with the alignment. You want to consciously focus on the alignment and then do it. But once your muscles get that memory of going into that pose with the proper alignment, then you need not be conscious about that. I mean, of course, you want to be aware of what you're doing. But then it's not like, it's fine. Once your elbows learn to get point back and once your chest needs to, you know, it gets the strength to stay a little up from the floor, then you don't have to consciously work on the alignment. But initially, first week or second week, you always want to be conscious about every muscle. Alright, so going a lot with the alignment right now, because I'm teaching it step by step. So the first step is to keep your shoulder and wrist aligned. Alright, now you don't want to be a little back, because that would be like pointing your elbows back if you do so. So you want to keep your shoulders and wrists aligned and then shift your body weight a little forward. So your chest, you see the chest is coming exactly between the palm and my face is ahead of the palm. So once you come here, then you want to walk your feet back, straighten your knees, and this is Dandasana. Now you want to drop your knees here. Now you may ask that you were already dropping the knees, why you went back and then drop. So let me show you the difference. If I keep my knees here, although my torso has the proper alignment, now if I bend the elbow, okay, I did it correctly. So now if I bend the elbow, so mostly I will go this way. My chest will press back and you see how hips are coming up. My knees are quite close. And if I walk back and then drop my knee, you yourself can see the distance, right? It makes a huge difference. So once you come here, then push your weight a little forward, keeping your chest exactly between the palm. You want to bend your elbow so that they point back and not side. And you want to go close to the mat. Now don't drop your chest. Just go lower your chest. Don't drop it. Once you learn to balance here, after 2 to 3 days, you can straighten your knee and come to full Chaturanga. Once you learn that, then you may go directly this way. And then you want to release your toes and come to Urdhva Mukha, upward facing. Exhale to Adho Mukha. So that we did was Baby Chaturanga. Once you master your Baby Chaturanga, you can easily do the full one. Now inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, step or hop forward. Look up halfway and hold your breath. Hold the pose, don't out the breath. And then exhale all the way down. Inhale, stretching your arms up, lengthening your spine. Exhale, relax. So we just did one Surya Namaskara with holdings and you can already feel that strength. So let's do another one. Inhale, stretch your arms up, gazing at the thumbs. Exhale, fold forward, palms beside your feet. 3 breaths here, deep and long. You can keep your knees soft, that's completely fine. Now keeping your hands either on the mat or on the shins, come to a nice flat back where you want to push your hips back, shoulders away from your ears. And then you want to bend your knees, either step or jump. You can even drop your knees and do the Baby Chaturanga, or you can keep your knees lifted and do the full Chaturanga. Inhale to Urdhva Mukha, toes released, and look up, few breaths. Exhale, lift your knees and come to Down Dog. Now from here, we're going to start the flow. So you want to turn the left foot at 45 degree angle and step the right forward between the palms. So today as we're working more on the strength, so I don't want you to keep like so much distance. Don't do that. Just keep a decent gap between both the feet, because you focus more on the strength and not on the flexibility. So you stay here and then you come up. Just check if the right knee is right above the ankle. That's very important. You keep your shoulders square and you stretch your arms up. Gazing at the thumbs, hold for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Opening your torso to the left side of the room where your shoulders completely open to left side. arms are open at shoulder level and you want to gaze at your right fingertip so that your head is moving, not the torso, and stay here. Just make sure that the weight is evenly shifted on both the legs. You may slightly feel more on the right, but that's all right. Oh, that's a rhyme. Hold for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. You're gonna keep the right left hand back onto your waist this way, wrapping it around, feeling your back. How flat is it with yoga? You wanna stretch your right arm up and bend towards your left. You wanna make sure that when you bend back, no one is straightened in. So keep it bent and stretch it up. Try to slightly bend towards left. And gazing at your right fingertips, hold for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Coming back center, place your palms down, step the right foot back, moving through your vinyasa. You can choose to do baby chaturanga or full chaturanga. Releasing your toes, inhale Urdhva Mukha, thighs and knees will be lifted, look up. Exhale Adho Mukha, downward facing. Now let's change sides. You want to do the same routine on the left. So you want to turn the right at 45. Step the left forward, keeping it between the palms. Left heel and right arch aligned, shoulders square. Stretch your arms up. Gaze at your thumbs. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Open your arms at shoulder level, keeping your shoulders nicely open. Gaze at your left fingertip and hold. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Keeping your right hand onto your waist, stretch your left arm up, bend slightly back and gaze at your left fingertips and hold. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Place both the palms down. Step the left foot back, moving through your vinyasa. Bend your elbows. Exhale Chaturanga. Inhale Urdhva Mukha. Rolling your shoulders back, look up. Exhale Adho Mukha. Heels grounded. Now you want to have some breaths here. So maybe you want to hold for 3 breaths. You can even keep your knees softly bent. That's alright. What works for you. And deep breaths. And relax. Now you're going to bend your knees, drop them and sit into Vajrasana. So I'm feeling super strong right now. My arms and my legs has been worked quite nicely. So working a little extra on the core, although you were working on your core as well while walking for all these things. But let's do our all-time favorite pose, Nokasana, because that works amazingly. I feel amazing on my lower abdomen, upper abdomen, my back and a little on the legs as well. So let's start with our Nokasana. So you want to stretch your legs forward, keeping your arms beside your body. Now if you have back related or neck related issues like slip disc or any kind of spondylitis, then what you can do, you can still do Nokasana but a modified version of that. So for all my other people who can easily do it, I'm going to show you first and then I'll show you the modified version after that. So you're going to straighten your knees and lift your legs up, keeping your toes nicely pointed. I'll come a little forward. And once you feel balanced, then you're going to stretch your arms beside your legs. Try to lift your chest slightly to the ceiling and hold. So this is for people who do not have any pain and want to strengthen their core and the, mostly core. So if you have back related pain, what you can do is, you can keep your knees softly bent. Still trying to keep your back straight and stretch your arms. You're still gonna feel that strength, but not a lot of pressure on the back, that would work. But still, it's definitely onto your body, how do you feel. If you're still not feeling comfortable, please don't do this. If you feel okay, if you feel comfortable, then go ahead and do this, okay? Understand the seriousness of pain. If it's a good pain or it's a serious pain, please understand and then do accordingly. So I'm gonna hold for 5, 4. If you were still holding, you're going to be super strong because you're almost hold for 15 seconds. And relax. Amazing. My back is feeling super strong right now. I can see my muscles burning. So you just want to hug your knees for a while here. Deep and long breaths. and relax. Lie down onto your back. Alright, so guys, now I'm gonna be teaching you Setu Bandhasan. Yeah, I know we do a lot of times, we do Setu Bandhasan quite a few times, almost in every class. But today, I will be teaching you what the asana actually means and how you can actually get into the final pose. It's very basic, but how do we do it, it matters the most, because I see a lot of people taking the support. Yes, of course, you can do that. But somehow you're missing the actual essence of that pose. So now first I'll demonstrate, then you please follow along. So how do you do Setu Bandhasan is, you lie down. Now the word says Setu Bandhasan. So the Setu is basically a bridge, what you form the shape of a bridge when you do Setu Bandhasan. Then the Bandha means lock. So when we do the bridge pose, where is the lock? So now I'm going to teach you where is it and how you can do it correctly. So you keep your knees bent. You keep your arms holding your ankle, or you can even rest them. So first you want to lift your pelvic up. So this is not the final pose. This is not Setu Bandhasan. If you can still move your head, you're not into the final pose. So first you lift your hips. Then you lift them higher and press it towards your face. So this way. So now do you see, once I push it a little forward, my chest comes so up that my chin locks to the chest. This is called Bandha. So your Setu is this. When you lock your chin to the chest, this is the Bandha, and then it becomes the final bridge pose. So make sure you only see the pose. If it's here, what do you see? If it's here, what do you see? It's quite high, right? So you really want to expand all those abdominal muscles. You want to make the lock of the chin to the chest, and that makes it the full Setu Bandhasan. And once you do this, honestly, without the arms, you're gonna feel amazing strength on your back and on your quadriceps. Like I do it most of the times to strengthen my quadriceps and my core. So please try it without support. Please try it with the alignment, and you'll really feel that strength. All right. So let's do it. Lifting it up and hold. I'm not able to count, guys. Please hold for at least 6 breaths, and I'll ask you to come back. Feel that strength on your legs. And relax. Slowly rest your hips down. And take a moment to just observe the thing that you just did. To observe the muscles. How you actually feel. Your entire spine, mostly the middle back and lower back, is feeling super strong. And the legs are like amazingly being worked on. So now let's just relax everything. So you want to bend both the knees, individually holding your knees with your palms. You want to press your knees into the chest. When you press it, you kind of lifting your lower back a little from the floor. That's okay. And then move side to side. This is my new favorite relaxing pose. When you move side to side, you feel so relaxed. So you're completely breathing out. And now open your arms at shoulder level. Keep your palms facing down towards the floor. Lifting your heels a little. Drop both the knees towards your right and look towards your left. Just twist your body and relax completely. Inhale. Coming back center. Drop both the knees towards left. Look towards right. I don't have space, so my heels are quite close to the hip, but you don't want to do that. Try and keep them a little away from your hip and feel the twist. Inhale, center, and press your knees into the chest with holding your elbows this time, so you can actually squeeze your knees quite well. And then roll your body up and down. Roll up and back. Nicely massage your spine and relax. Relax into Shavasana, keeping your body nicely relaxed, feet apart, palms facing roof. Completely relax. Eyes closed. Deep inhale and exhale. Let your body relax completely. Relax each and every part. And now bring your feet together. Stretch your arms back and feet forward. Stretch your body completely. And relax. Turn towards one side and sit up.
If you are aware of Nadi Shodhan practice, then you don't want to open your eyes. If not, you can open your eyes and practice Nadi Shodhan Pranayam with me. So keep your right hand in Nasik Mudra, bending your first two fingers. Of course, the mudra can be of your choice. Then you close your right nostril with the thumb and start inhaling from your left. Make sure the breath is very deep and long. Closing it, exhale from another. Inhale from the same. Exhale from another. Keep breathing. Exhale and complete the practice. Don't open your eyes directly. Rest your hand back onto the knee in Shin Mudra. Take a moment to observe your body and feel the vibrations, feel the relaxation, feel the positivities. Appreciate yourself for all the efforts and be grateful for your time on the mat. And now start rubbing your palms. Keep rubbing until they get warm and cup your eyes. Just feel that warmth and with a beautiful smile on your face, open your eyes and look at the palms. Your palms want to see the smiling face, so don't forget to smile and relax. Thank you so much everyone. Hope you guys enjoyed the class and feeling stronger like I do. Do let me know if you have any question or if you want to say something. Your feedbacks are welcome. So do let me know how do you feel right now. This live goes a little late, so I have to wait for the comments like for a minute. Because you guys post it and then I get it a minute later. So yeah. Thank you so much for sending all these hearts. Mama, please. Is that, do you asking sun bath? Yeah, it's good. It's really amazing. So now that you've started like the topic, so let me go a little into detail. Okay, thank you so much guys. I'm feeling really good that you guys enjoyed the class and saying so much good about it. You guys are welcome so much. Thank you. You guys are saying thanks a ton. Thank you so much. Okay guys, so let's talk about the importance of sun today. I mean, I think I have 5 minutes, so I'll just explain a little. Nowadays, I hear a lot of people saying, mostly the beauty bloggers, they say that you should wear sunscreen even when you're at home. If you're stepping out of the home, you should wear sunscreen. Of course, you should do that, but it's not like you are going to wear that at home. And we have vitamin D already in the body. Like, this is the myth that sun gives vitamin D. No, it doesn't. You already have that vitamin D in your body, but it can only be synthesized if you go into sun. If you get the sun rays in your body, that vitamin D will be synthesized. And you guys know, I don't have to explain the importance of vitamin D in the body. It's very, very important for your bones, for your ligaments. So it's important that you also go and, you know, express your body. What should I say? Express is not the word, but yeah, you should expose a little to the sun. Even your skin needs a lot of sun, even your body needs, but make sure you go. There's a time, right? So I stay in Rajasthan, so here I think after 10 I cannot go because it's very, very sharp. But if you are in Mumbai or if you're somewhere where the sun is not that sharp, so you can take a time starting from the 7, but 7 I think the sun is not that like sharp, you don't get the rays. Then you can go till 12 or maybe 11, and then you can get the vitamin D synthesis in your body. That's very important. Please don't wear sunscreen at your home. Please don't. You are protecting your body so much that it's not even getting what is essential for it. So please do not wear sunscreen at home. You wear it only if you are stepping out of the home and when the UV rays are so strong that you don't want to hurt your skin and don't make it red and all, so then you can wear. But at home, before 11, before 12, please don't wear it. Expose it a little to the sun. And once a week, I suggest you all, please go to your rooftop or wherever the sun comes, by your balcony or wherever. Go with the least clothing on your body and lightest clothes, like maybe white. And lightest, you know the meaning of lightest. Okay, so like very light t-shirt or shorts or whatever. Least clothes on your body and go to your balcony or your rooftop, wherever the sun comes. And let your body expose to the sun. It's very important for your body to, get those rays. So yeah, that's something which I wanted to talk from a long time. And I finally talked about it. So hope you guys understood. Okay, so Zofia Z is asking that taking steam is good, ma'am. Yes, it's very good. But then I cannot say that it would be good for you or for me. Because you really have to check what skin type do you have. For some people, it may not suit. And for some, it is amazing. So yeah, I think you wanna do some testing and you will only come to know about your body only if you test. So I go to at least a face steam and then I check if it suits me and then I can go for entire body steam bath. So that is something. It's good, but yeah, it's very good. It's naturopathy. Yeah, it's very good. It's very good. Okay guys, I think I've answered all the questions, but you still have any question, you can direct message me. Okay, my handle is Siddhi Parikh and your questions would be welcome. I love to answer anything. So thank you so much for joining in. Hope you guys enjoyed and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a good day. Stay healthy. Bye bye.